Hello dear, in this video we are going to discuss about phases of compiler. So as we know, compiler is a software that converts any high-level language to the assembly level code. Okay, so it is like it doesn't mean that it takes the entire program and directly convert it into a assembly level code. Like there are some intermediate things, like there are some phases of compiler involved in it. Like the structure of a compiler goes at different levels. Okay, to convert any high level language to machine level code, like not machine level code, it is assembly level code for your compiler. And usually, like we have grouped this phases, different phases of compiler into two different phases. One is analysis phase, another one is synthesis phase. Okay, so this analysis phase analyze the code. Analysis in the sense, it checks for the syntactic structure. It actually put a grammatical structure, like it syntactically form a graph like structure, a tree like structure for your source code. And the synthesis code, as it means, it is going to generate a code out of it. Okay, so analysis is to analyze the code and checks whether it is syntactically and semantically meaningful. It is good, and then it is going to put an intermediate representation for the source code. Whereas the synthesis phase, it takes that parse tree, whatever it is, and converts that to and synthesize the code, intermediate code out of it. Okay, so in general, we call this analysis phase as a front end of compiler, and this as a back end of compiler. Okay, and again, the different phases comes as, like in analysis, we have lexical analyzer, syntax and semantic. Okay, so lexical analyzer will checks for the meaningful representation. Like it takes a program, analyze code by code, like as a lexeme by lexeme. Okay, so it takes an entire source program and converts that into some set of tokens, some meaningful tokens. Okay, and syntax analyzer checks the syntactic structure of the code. Okay, so the like each and every programming language, it has its own syntactic structure, so we have to verify whether syntactically it is correct or not. Okay, so and the output is passed to, like it generates a parse tree and it is passed to the semantic analyzer. So semantic analyzer phase actually checks the meaningfulness of the code. Okay, whether it is the meaning of the code is paka or not. Okay, so these are all like not the logical thing, only the meaningful thing is analyzed over here. Okay, so these all three phases comes under analysis phase, and under synthesis phase we have intermediate code generation, and then you have code optimization and code generation. So it is all generation, right? We are going to synthesize the code out of it. Okay, so out of the output of this semantic analyzer is passed to intermediate code generator. It actually generates a code. Okay, some three address codes will be generated from the parse tree, and the generated code will have so much of temporary variables and all. So we are going for this code optimization phase, which optimize the number of lines of codes, and finally we are going to generate an assembly level code out of it. So we take source code as an input written in a high level language, and it need to be converted to an assembly level code. Okay, so along with all these things, we have two different data structures that accompany this process of your compilation. So that is, one is symbol table. Okay, so symbol table is a structure, is a data structure that actually stores the information about the source program. Usually like storing all the set of variables, identifiers and all, so that is done by the symbol table. Okay, and you have something called error handling mechanism, error handler. So each phases, it checks for the error in case if any error comes over there. So this error handler is responsible for handling the error and reporting that to user. Okay, so as I told you, analysis phase need to analyze the code, right? In case if there is any error in the syntactic structure or a semantic structure of a code, that need to be reported, right? And that is handled by this error handling mechanism. So this is the entire thing that describes about phases of compiler. In general, we have analysis phase, synthesis phase. Analysis phase, analyze the code. Analyze whether the code is syntactically and semantically meaningful. And the synthesis phase will generate a code out of this, like an intermediate code, optimize it, and final assembly level code will be generated. And the analysis phase is called the front end of it, and synthesis phase is called the back end of it. So along with all these six phases, we have two data structures that accompany this process. One is symbol table. So symbol table is used to store the information about the source code. And error handler, in case if there exists any error, like if an error is detected, might be a syntactic or semantic error, so that need to be handled. And this error handler is used for handling the error. Now we'll take an example and see how a data source code will be